It feels so right when I do man wrong. You're doing it wrong if your ops ain't flag. Three of them got knifed, the other got knifed.
What is good? How are we? I'm balancing this on my steering wheel now. Hair's looking a bit shit. We're away to Manchester. Today is Thursday. Driving down. It'll be a 4-hour drive. Picking up my pal Roberto. And we are away to the coach convention. Some of the best online coaches, or if not the best online coaches in the world. In the UK. World UK. Physique Collective guys. Callum Raystrike from Pro Coach, Josh Bridgman, TM Cycles, Joe Brightman, AJ Morris will be a guest speaker, and Rough Diesel will be on Zoom as well. It's like a networking event as well for like online coaches, so it'll be fucking sick. Body rotting, the roaches robbing, shotgun blasting me faster than a robin. 11 plus 1 was the gun that popped him. Blast on a pass all the times we were jogging. I stepped last night, I don't really do it often. Four-door truck like soft just strolling. They already know this, my mum condones it. CC back, Manchester, Manchester, that is where we were. Good weekend, man. I say weekend, it was a Thursday, Friday. We were supposed to come back on the Saturday, but we came back early. But yeah, regardless of that, the title of the video, gain more muscle with these training tips. Okay, I genuinely believe if you use these tips, you are likely going to gain a little bit more muscle. All right. The first number one tip being quality over quantity. All right. Look at your training, okay, and look at the amount of sets you're doing per week, all right? Usually with a client or with myself, I'll have a set amount of sets that I'm doing per week. So for chest, that might be 20 sets of chest work a week. Quite a lot of people, okay, will be doing way too fucking many, all right? What you need to look at doing, more sets, more sets, more sets, doesn't always mean more growth, because at the end of the day, we want a set to be of a high quality. It's the quality of a set that builds muscle. Every set is a chance to gain new muscle tissue, okay? So if you're just doing poor quality, shit sets and adding them on. So if you're doing like 7 sets of fucking chest press, all right? The first 2, 3, maybe 4 are probably of a good quality. You can probably progress them. As soon as you get to set 5, 6, 7, you're probably not progressing them. In fact, you definitely aren't. I've been training for years and I've never progressed a 5th or a 6th or a fucking 7th set of something. All right, you're not progressing. You're not getting more reps. You're not getting more load on the bar. And if you are, I just don't think you're training hard enough. Sorry to say. So quality over quantity. On that note, split your workload, okay? So what I mean by that is if you are doing, you know, 20 sets of chest a week, all right, split that workload up. So don't just do 20 sets on the one session, split them in. What do you think is going to be better quality? And that brings us back to quality over quantity. Do you think doing 20 sets of chest work in one session is going to be more productive and you'll have better sets? Or would you have better working sets doing 10 sets of chest on a Monday and then 10 sets of chest on a Thursday? What would give you more quality? Yeah, you're right. Splitting up, so now you've not only had better quality sets, but you've also hit the muscle more frequently, which brings me on to my second point. Train the muscle more frequently. If a muscle's not grown and you're only training it once or twice a week, ask yourself, could I train this 3 times a week? All right? So that's the first batch of tips. What is good, my guys? How are we? Hope we are well. You would have seen from a couple of clips there as we were in Manchester, we were down for the coach convention. I planned to get more stuff video down there, but I didn't want to walk around with my camera out and the iPhone quality. You're used to filming with a camera now. Oh, big stuff, you know. And I didn't want to really film everything there, and plus we didn't do anything exciting. Went down the Thursday. Got there, had a gym session, which you'd have seen clips of, FLF gym, wow, what a damn gym. Went for food later on at night. The plan was to stay and go out on Saturday night after the event. Go out on Friday night after the event, but we were fucked pretty much. The plan would have been to drive home early Saturday anyway, so we just came back on the Friday. So yeah, back home now, free t-shirt. Oh, it's better than a t-shirt that you pay for. A free t-shirt. Probably just wear this about the house. It's a bit of a shitter, but we'll wear it. Yeah, what have we got planned today? Saturday, upper body session again. Feels good being back home though, but that 2 days there, literally just ate out every single day. On Thursday, I think I had a regular breakfast in the house before I drove up. Had like a McDonald's halfway through. Had a KFC, had a Nando's, some rice cakes. On the Saturday, McDonald's breakfast, had the whole event, had a Pepe's burger, and then a Greg's baguette, sausage roll. And now I'm back home, and I've lost weight. I've lost £4. a lot of water has been lost. I wasn't drinking too much water there. 2 days, not a big deal. Back in my element, back on plan, training, eating, sleeping, doing all that good shit. Very motivated after that event as well. Seeing all these guys fucking killing it, and knowing that all these guys as well, they feel sense of like overwhelmed. They feel senses of like shit that normal people do like us, because they are normal people. They've just got a following and are making bigger bank. But guess what? So we one day. So yeah, enjoy this vlog or whatever's going on. God damn, in the garage. Gonna jump on this bad boy. Not for cardio, for steps. I don't have a treadmill, so this is my next best bet. I just guess the steps on it. I'll use my app on my phone because I lost my Apple Watch and I need to buy a new one. But that whole weekend there, well, yesterday especially, because I was driving for 4.5 hours of the day and we're sat in a hall for 6, 7, 8 hours. 6, 7, 8 hours, it's a very diverse number. No movement, so when I don't move, I feel a bit and I've just got hundreds of fast food sitting in my stomach. So gonna just move on this for 15-20 minutes, get the bowels moving, hopefully do a shit upstairs after that, have a pre-workout meal, go to the gym. But right now, gonna get some movement. Let's go.
I used to see a guy, right? I'm gonna position that camera different.
Lol, I used to see a guy, right?
In the gym, the first gym I worked at, in Pure Gym, and this is what he would do on the cross trainer. Don't get me wrong, it's pretty damn fun. This is what he would do. He'd go on one leg, and he'd sit and do that for fucking ages, man. He'd literally have a 30 minute interval on this thing, but he would do this the whole time. Wow, man. That guy must have been having a great fucking time, man. A great time. One more gram. One more gram. It's never just one more, is it? No. Bit of dark chocolate. Let's spread that shit over. That'll do it. OCD, mate. OCD. Let that melt. As you can see, we've covered it with some lovely ass blueberries and raspberries. Dark chocolate's melted. And come back here with the sugar-free syrup, the best one you'll ever use. I know you've probably seen this recipe countless times, but I'm going to keep on making it until every single fucking person that eats oats has this recipe. And then we have the caramel biscuit protein powder paste going over the top of that. And I'm telling you something right now, this is an art. This isn't just oats, this is an art. And I don't think I'll ever get sick of this, man. Unbelievable, Jack. Unbelievable.
How about them for some damn drill beats? Eh, we like that. We like that, yeah. Cool, running over a upper body day here with some more tips on gaining more muscle. Upper body training is 3 times a week right now. It seems to be growing, so happy with it. So, one thing I want to touch on is covering a wide variety of different angles and ranges. All right, let's look at chest, since we're training chest. You know, we can challenge it in a lengthened range, so when the muscle is fully stretched here, it's going to be any sort of press, any press you do where the elbow comes back behind the body is a fully stretched pec. All right, even when you're doing like a fly variation, you can lengthen and stretch the pec. But then we also want to pick movements where we can contract the chest. So if we look at a dumbbell press, the dumbbells move closer towards the body when you come in, so we've got tension throughout the full range, so we can utilize things like flies, presses. A good press would be one that converges in, so your hands get closer together. So, you know, every muscle group has got movements to cover different ranges. If we look at legs, we've got a squat pattern, which puts the quads in a fully lengthened position. We've got a leg press that works at sort of mid position, and we've got a leg extension that works the quads when they're fully contracted. So with every single muscle group, work through completely different ranges and cover a wide spread, and that'll make sure that you're using every last ounce of musculature on that muscle. Don't just stick to one range, all right? Unless obviously injury prevention, you've got really gammy fucked up knees, then maybe you won't be able to squat to full depth. But yeah, that's gonna be the one of the main points there, covering a wide spread of movement patterns and ranges, all right? So the next kind of point is actually use the muscle to lift that weight, all right? And I've definitely been guilty of not doing this before. And as soon as I sort of corrected this and sort of took it on board,
like, man, like, it just, you just need to drop the ego sometimes. And I've had clients doing that as well, where they've sent me over videos of their own form, and I'm like, listen, just drop the ego. The goal, do you, nobody gives a shit about how much you can single arm lat pull down. Nobody asks you that. So who cares about how much weight you're doing on it? Obviously, you want to be beating your own numbers over time, whether that's 10 kilo or 2 kilo. Progression is progression. So use the muscle to lift the weight. Again, how can we do that a little bit better? We can just slow things down a little bit, all right? Don't rush the movement. Keep form on point. So look at this row, for example. Chest is against the pad. I retract the elbows and squeeze the back. I get a tiny wee pause when I'm up at the top. And no point is there momentum used here. It's the muscle I'm trying to train. Too many people train movements. They just do the movement, but they don't actually try and train the muscle. Slow things down. Try and develop that mind-muscle connection, where that might mean you need to maybe pause when you're contracted and pause when the muscle is stretched, and that might give you a bit of a better mind-muscle connection, but that will also make sure that you're using the damn muscle, all right? And then to further add on that point, all right, I'll quickly wrap these up into two. Form is the first thing that you should prioritize over everything. Form builds muscle, all right? I don't care what you're doing. Make sure form is intact. In line with that, progress your training, all right? Progress your training over time, whether that be extra reps with the same weight or more load on the bar, all right? Take your time with progressions. If you're too quick with it and the ego can take over and everything I've mentioned in this video will go to shit if you let the ego take over. So drop the ego, clean everything up, use the muscle, progress over time, quality over quantity. I can't remember the points in the top of my head right now, but that's some of my biggest tips for gaining more musculature. So enjoy this little physique update with a nice hard drill beat over it, and enjoy the video. Drop it a like, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.
TSAD will come, boys. We really grease up enough, boys. Knife game, yuck, plus we bullet up enough, boys. Dinosaurs extinct when got caught. Orcs. Practice what I preach, really play my sports. Of course. I like roads with tents and outlines of chalk. Forks. I like enemy too, I'm a bit of a dork. Pause. Got bank on the show, no remorse. Had this gang front row when we played with a corpse.